How do you like teaching?
Not very much. Well, I'm a very bad teacher. That's sort of a sad thing. But, I mean, sometimes I give courses, but sometimes I start off a lesson with enthusiasm. Mm-hmm. But sometimes I can get bored. You know, I lose a vitality. Mm-hmm. And then I don't think that's very good for a teacher to be like that. Mm-hmm. And so I think when I get older, I'll probably do some more teaching. I did many years ago, taught a lot. Mm-hmm. But that was before you were born, you know.
I heard a lot about this BBC courses.
Yeah.
With TV.
Oh, yeah.
And I saw this on TV.
Did you? Yeah. How was that? I mean, was it interesting?
It's long
time ago, yeah. Yes, that was quite good. I quite like taking a class of students.
Yeah.
But taking students individually, I find it's not so stimulating, but if I got a very good player, well then it's marvellous, you know, mm-hmm. because you can do something, you can help create something.
Mm-hmm.
But it's I'd much rather coach a string quartet
mm-hmm.
in an interpretation of Haydn or Beethoven than teach the coach a guitar, unless the guitar player is musical, you know, then good.
Mm-hmm.
But for an ordinary player, you know, there are many better teachers than me. I mean, this is the point. I mean, if one was good at it, then it would be different. But I mean, since there are better teachers than I am, particularly on technical things, then it's better that a student goes to that sort of teacher.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm quite good on musical interpretation. Mm-hmm.
You have done a lot of recordings. What do you think generally about recordings and recordings?
Well, I think they're interesting. You know,
mm-hmm.
I much prefer to give concerts, and I much prefer to go to a concert than listen to a gramophone record of anything. But I think they're useful gramophone records.
For students,
for sure, example. And I think for people that live in the country and can't get to concerts.
Mm-hmm. How do you put together the pieces of a record? And what is about the influence of the producers? Is there an influence?
Well, they do suggest sometimes I do things, but I'm always thinking about how to make the next gramophone record. And I try to make a theme, you know, I try to do one or two composers, perhaps mm-hmm. for the same period, or just a complete contemporary music, or just complete chamber music, or I'm not so keen just on a ad hoc series of pieces, like at a concert.
Also, the greatest hits of the...
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's it. I think a record ideally should have a theme, you know, and then you do variations on that theme.
You are the editor of the Faber Guitar Series.
Yeah.
What was your motive for this edition?
It was just to... I'd made a number of arrangements in the 50s, and I just thought it was a pity not to publish some of them. The Faber Music Company started 12 years ago. No. 18 years ago. Then they were. So I thought that would be very nice to put my transcriptions with them.
Mm-hmm.
Because they wanted to start a library, you see. It's very hard to start a publishing house from the very beginning. Mm-hmm. You've got nothing. So I thought that was a good venture to do.
Mm-hmm. Among all your editions, there are a lot of contemporary pieces. This is a kind of advancement to the new music.
Well, it's just, I think it's very important that music, contemporary music, good contemporary music is written for the instrument. And it means that for a younger generation of players, there is already a nucleus of contemporary music for them to play. Right? I think that's very useful.
How important are the concerts for you in your life?
Very, very important. Yeah. Because I like the contact, with the audience, the flow, the electricity.
Yeah.